video, I'm going to show how to edit the grids and the number of stories. So I'm just going to use the built-in settings. So click on OK. And here by default, there are number of grids and spacing already arranged. So if you want to change as per your model, then you can change it here. So for example, I'm going to keep number of grid lines in X direction as 3, and for Y direction, let it be 4. So in by X direction, the spacing would be something around 5 meters, and coming to Y direction, let it be 3 meters. Okay, so the grids will be placed perpendicular to the axis. Say for example, this is X axis. If you are giving number of grids in X direction is 3, so this is 1 grid, 2nd and 3rd. Okay, so if each grid is 4 meters, so this will be 4 meters and this will be also 4 meters. Okay, similarly in Y direction, so since Y direction is in this direction, we are going to get the horizontal grids like this. Okay, so each grid spacing is about 3 meters. So in this way, we can define the grid numbers and grid spacings. And if you want to adjust the bubble size of the grid, then click on the custom grid space, click on the edit grid data. And here we are going to have the bubble size. Okay, so let me decrease it to 500 mm. So click on OK. And here the simple story data. Okay, so number of stories, let it be 4, and typical story height is 3 meters and bottom story height is 4.5 meters for example. Okay, so let us see how can we add or delete the number of stories on the grid, or we can edit the normal grid, XY direction grid also. So I'm going for uniform grid spacing and simple story data, which is of equal typical story height. So after selecting, after assigning these all the things, click on OK. And automatically the grid will be assigned on the screen like this. So we got 6 meters in X direction, and this is also 6 meters. Okay, wait one second. So in order to edit the grids again, so since I kept customization and again I went for the uniform spacing, so the sizes has been changed here. So let us change it again. So in order to change the grid spacing, so in this video I am going to discuss that only. So just go for right click and click on add or modify grids. So here we are going to have the G1 system. If you want to add a new grid system, you can click on add new grid system also. But let us modify this one first. So modify. Here it has been taken as 6 by 6 spacing. So let us change it for 5 by 5 for example. 5, and next one is also 10. So it will be arranged in absolute. Okay. And here under rectangular grids, we are having display grid data as coordinates. It will be like 0, 0. X coordinate is 0 and Y coordinate is also 0. And similarly, next at B, it will be 5, 6. So instead of that, you can go for display grid data as spacing. If you are getting confused with the ordinates, you can go for display grid data as spacing. Okay, so if A to B grid is 5 and similarly this is also 5, and let it be something around 6 meters and this is something around 4.5 meters. So let it be 666 in Y spacing. So after creating these all the things, click on OK and let us modify the bubble size also. So just going for this, let me keep it as 500. Click on OK and click on refresh view, and we can see the changes on the screen here. Okay, so since we have kept 5 by 5 in X direction, we got this. Yeah, 5, 5 and 16, right? So we got the 5, 5, 6 here. Okay, so it automatically updated here. We can simply click on OK again. So just in order to check, I hope I have opened that window again. So in this way, we can edit the XY plane. Similarly, if you want to edit the number of stories, okay. So again, you can go for the right click, add, modify grids. And here we are going to get the story data at the top side, okay. So just click on modify or show story data. So here story 4, 3, 2, 1 is there, and base is also there, okay. So the story 1 height is 4.5 meters that from the base level. Similarly, all the typical floor heights are 3, okay. So if you want to change the height of that one, simply you can change. For example, from story 2 to 3, let it be 4. And you can see that the cumulative elevation has been changed here. Okay. Starting from the base level, the story 1 height was 4.5. So the elevation is also 4.5. Coming to the story 2, individual height is 3, but added or cumulative value is 7.5. Like 4.5 plus 3 is 7.5. In this way, we can get the total elevation of the structure also. Okay, and here we can see that story 3 is similar to story 4 and story 2 is similar to story 5, story 4. Okay, so if you want to change the, you want to match up with any other story, you can change it here. Okay, so let it be like this. So I have changed the height here and we get the elevation here. So click on refresh view and all the elevations will be changed on the screen. So click on OK. In this way, we can edit the grid and as well as the stories on the screen.